Good morning, everybody. I hope you had a nice holiday. This is a welcome video for Chem 152, which meets Tuesday synchronously in the spring of 2021. My name is Rob Fremlin. I'll be your tour guide on this journey. So what I want to do today, other than welcoming you, so welcome, is to go over the syllabus for the course as well as the website. So let me just jump right in and tell you what the course is about. So do a screen share here. All right. So this is the syllabus for the course, and this is the website. The website is on Canvas, all right? So let's go through the syllabus. So first of all, very important to know what Chem 152 is and what it is not. Chem 152 is prep chem. This course is designed with the assumption that you've never taken chemistry before, but you need to take general chemistry. That means that you're gonna go into our general chemistry course, probably a science major. General chem is Chem 200 and 201. In our district. So if you're some majors, like a lot of the allied health majors require actually just Chem 100. So you might want to look at your major, make sure you're in the right course. If you're a liberal arts major, like a history major or a soc major, Chem 111 is probably the course for you. That being said, that's what this course is. So you can read the course description. I do assume you can do math. So if I say it's just algebra from here, don't want you freaking out on me. Okay. You should be able to do it. You might want to refresh your memory if it's been a while. Course objectives you can read, blah, blah, blah. All right, as far as the textbook goes, this is the textbook. There's a paperback version that looks a little bit different. You can get any version. You can get the ebook, you can get the loose leaf book. I don't care, but I want you to have the book. I even allow old editions, but I only have information going back to the fifth, but you can certainly use an old edition, a used book, but you definitely want the book. You should definitely read it. It should be a very, very important resource. Right. In addition, this is a fully online course. That means you need obviously reliable internet. I am going to ask you to upload some documents, some scratch paper and things like that. So some means to make a document into a PDF. I know there's some free apps for phones that you can do, so you can upload them as PDFs. Also, a printer is access to a printer is a nice idea. Right. So those are some things that you might want to make sure you have available. I will have office hours via Zoom, Mondays and Wednesdays from 10 to 12, Tuesdays and Thursdays from 10 to 11. If you want to talk to me some other time, just shoot me an email and we can work something out. Okay, this is the link to the Zoom site. It's also in the Canvas site, all right? And that's my email, and this is the password to the Zoom. All right, this is a fully online course, but there will be times I want you to be online the same time as me, and that's going to be most Tuesdays. So Tuesdays at 8 o'clock, today is Tuesday, or if you're watching this, today is actually Monday, but I will be talking about this stuff on the first day, which is February 2nd. I'm going to want you on Zoom with me on most Tuesday mornings. If we're not going to do it one Tuesday, I will let you know. Now, I don't require that your video is on except during exams. But for example, one of the things we'll do during those Tuesday sessions is exams. And on exams, I do want your video on. Any other time, that's completely optional. It's nice to see your face, but not absolutely required. All right. What we will be doing, I'll talk about, well, what we're going to do most of the time are in-class activities. I will not be lecturing for this course. All the lectures are on Canvas, and I'll go through that in a minute. April 16th is the last day to drop, right? So make sure, don't assume you'll be dropped by anybody in any class. Assume that you have to do it. All right, so let me go through materials. Basically, everything is on Canvas. So this is the Canvas site. Canvas site has several modules. I'm just leaving one or two of them open today so you can see them. All right. Basically, there's the welcome module, and this will be the welcome video. This is last semester's right now, but it'll be this one that I'm recording today. This is your syllabus. This is the lecture schedule, so let me just show you what that looks like as it comes up. All right, so each week, kind of this is what's due and what you should be doing and what textbook sessions you should be, you should be reading. And I have it for each week. I will be sending, hopefully most Sundays, I'm gonna send an announcement sometime on Sunday, usually in the evening, to remind you what you should be doing for the upcoming week. All right, this is the link to the Zoom account. I doubt I'll make changes in that. I just went through it recently, but if I do, I'll let you know. Link to the Zoom account. This is linked to Student Services. Student Services has a lot of services available. They can help you with, you know, making career decisions. They can help you find jobs. Counseling, of course, is there, so good idea. Academic honesty is a big deal, especially in an online environment. So one of the first assignments I want you to do, I want you to print this document, read it, sign it, and then I want you to upload it as a PDF, and you'll upload it through Canvas right here. All right, so I want you to do that ASAP. I'm going to keep a record of those. The rest of this, just to show you how the course is structured. So there's basically four modules. I know they're big, but this is how I broke them up. So each module is going to have the lecture, and this is a PowerPoint of the lecture that you're supposed to read. Underneath that are videos, and the videos are YouTube videos of me lecturing over the slides. And so basically you're going to see the slides and you're going to hear me talking, and in addition, because what I strongly recommend you do is open the slides, run the slides along with the video, and certainly because it's a video, you can hit pause and you can back up and go forward. And that's kind of the idea behind this. There'll be a lot of times in the videos where I literally say, hit pause now, try this on your own. All right. So again, I'm not going to be going over doing this in class sessions. I'm expecting you to do this on your own. All right. This is also where all the activities will be. So this is an in-class activity, which I'll talk about. This is the homework assignments and things like that, right? Exam way down here and so on, all right? Now, a couple other things that are available, if you scroll down, these are the other modules. This is some helpful hints about test anxiety. These are the homework keys. So you can see they're not published yet, but once you turn in, when you turn in homework one and I grade it and you get it back, I'm going to make the answer key available so you can go over all the questions and you can see what the answers were. In addition, I have here exam keys. So these are the keys to the exams I gave last semester. Now they look a little bit different because I give the exams through Canvas, but they are literally the questions with the answers. And so that is a good mechanism for you to study for the exams. So you can use that to study for your exam, because exam one this semester, it's not going to be the same test, but it's the same guy writing a test over the same material. So it's likely going to be very similar. And so I recommend, you know, they're Word documents. So you could take them down, you could erase the answers. I think actually they might be PDFs, but you could take them down, erase the answers, and literally take it like it's a test if you wanted to. Once you take, I'm leaving these up, but after you take your exam one and after it's graded and given back to you, I'll take this one down, but I'll put up the answer key to your exam one for the spring of 21. And that way you'll have a good feel for, you can look at that and you can see what the right answers were, the solutions to the problems, and that will help you prepare for the final. All right, so that's how everything is organized, right? Each module ends with the exam over that unit. All right, now the in-class participation, this is how the course is graded. So as you can see here, for example, this is an in-class activity on February 9th. These are going to be Zoom sessions. So this is what we'll do during the Zoom sessions on Tuesday. So again, I'm not gonna lecture. I can certainly answer questions, but I'm gonna, on the 9th, for example, I'm gonna open this up. I'll say good morning, and then I'll break you up into breakout rooms through Zoom, and you can work on this together. And it's just a list of questions that you're to work out and then upload on an answer sheet, or upload it, you know, worked out. And then I'll move through the breakout rooms and answer any questions, help you with the problems. And then typically with about 20 minutes to go, I'll close the breakout rooms, and then I'll go through all of them on a whiteboard. And that way you can get the right answers. All right. Now, these are only going to be during our synchronous sessions. Now, the way I'm going to grade these are only going to count on your grade if you're within 1% of the next grade. So if you're 1% below a B and you've done the synchronous sessions, you've done the in-class sessions, I'll raise your grade. You have to get 2/3 of the points, all right? So the way the points are, if you at least did half the problems, you'll get 1 point. If you did all the problems, you'll get 2 points. And of course, being in the Zoom session is the third point. So if you get 2/3 of the points and you're 1% below the next grade, I'll raise your grade. Now, again, these are going to be helpful anyway, because it's a good opportunity to get practice on problems and stuff like that, all right? So that's what and those will be only in-class sessions. Homework, okay, so if you look at homework, just to show you what a homework looks like, this is homework one, all right? And homework one, so homeworks, there's 14 of them. I'm going to count the best 13. It's a bunch of questions like this, and you answer the questions on a separate sheet of paper, and then you're going to upload them. Now, the way I grade it, so what you'll see if you look at the actual, this part here, this is homework one, the questions, and then this is the homework one, so to speak. It's structured as a quiz. And if you look at it, the first question is upload the completed questions from the space above. And then these are also, these are five of the questions that I chose that I'm gonna have you put in Canvas, and I'll actually grade these. So homeworks are graded on a 10-point basis. 5 points is for doing all the questions and uploading it. And then the other 5 points are if you get those other questions right, all right? And so homework's 10% of the grade, but doing the homework is very important because it's the same types of questions that you'll see on exams. So really a good idea. Like I said, I'm gonna, five of it's just for doing it, including the book questions, and then the other five are just the questions in Canvas. All right, of the 14 homeworks, I'll count the best 13, they're 10 points each. It's 10% of the grade. All right, exams, okay, there's gonna be 4 midterms and a final. The midterms are gonna be done during these synchronous sessions. And as I said, I want your camera on during the exams just to, you know, kind of, you know, keep you honest, so to speak. Most people don't cheat, but just in case. Now, during an exam, of course, you can only look at, obviously you'll be given a periodic, you'll have a periodic table that you can look up, and that's it. So you're not to be going through lecture notes, you're not to be going through the book, looking things up on the internet, not during an exam. The exam is only open during that window, and I want you there with your camera on. There are 100 points each, they'll all be in Canvas. Okay, in addition, I want you, not for the truth, not for questions, but for any problems, and chemistry is very problem solving, anything that's a math problem, I want you to do it on a separate sheet of paper in addition, and then the last question on the exam is gonna be upload your scratch paper. Now there's 2 reasons for that. One, I want you to do the work, and but most importantly, it's for partial credit. So if the answer, let's say you got the answer wrong, and it's a 10-point question, but when I look at your work, I see, oh, I see, you just didn't multiply by 2 in that one part of the problem where you had to multiply by 2, you forgot that step. Well, you're gonna get 8 out of 10. Canvas doesn't know that, and so you know, I'll have to go through, I'll fix it. So that's why it's very important. However, to keep you honest, so to speak, even if you got the answer right, but there's no work turned in on it, I'm not gonna give you any credit for it. So you gotta do the work and upload it, right? You'll get used to doing this. I did this last semester, it worked really well. All right, so there's 4 midterm exams, they're 100 points each. And again, if you look at the old exams, they're gonna be similar. 100 points each, I count the best 3. As I said, the answer keys will be posted after you do your exam. Exams are 90% of the grade. Okay, makeup exams, I need to know ahead of time. So if you wake up that morning and you're really sick or something came up, shoot me an email and I can open the exam at a different time, but I don't like to do that. So, you know, try to be there. All right, final exam, I can't do during a synchronous session just because of the timing. So the final exam, you are gonna have a little bit, you're gonna have a longer window, you're gonna have the same amount of time to do the exam. Most exams are like an hour and a half, 90, 95 minutes. For the final, you have the same amount of time to actually do it, but you'll have a couple of days in which to do it. So you can't do part of it and come back. So you wanna sit down and have the 95 minutes to do the exam, but it's gonna be open from the May 26th until May 28th, all right? The final, same type of test, same structure, it's only 100 points. I throw out the lowest of the midterms, but I do not throw out the final. So here's the grading scheme. There's 14 homeworks, I'm counting the best 13. There's 4 midterm exams, I'm counting the best 3. There's the final, all right? 90% times exam percent, 0.1 times the homework percent, I add them together, that's your grade. And again, the in-class sessions, if you get 18 of the 27 and you're within 1%, I'll raise your grade. All right, a couple more things. Any type of disability, there's nothing I can do if I'm unaware. Just shoot me an email and we can work something out, all right? The last thing, this is just some good advice. So you're taking this course online, so time management is very important. You can do stuff at 2 in the morning for all I care, but don't expect me to, you know, be answering questions, and you can shoot me an email or something. I'll answer it when I open my email in the morning. But I'm only gonna be online, you know, during certain windows of time as it says in the syllabus. But, you know, make sure you manage your time well. Give yourself plenty of time to go over the lectures and go over the videos, go back and forth, do them twice if you need to. Make sure you give yourself time to read the textbook, all of that stuff that you need to do, all right? So make sure you take care of all that. Give yourself time. And that's number one on here, manage your time, all right? Don't let the class intimidate you. Everyone told me, oh, chemistry is so hard. And it is, it's challenging, but you can do it. You know, you just have to put the time in. All right, reading the textbook, I said, very, very important. Come to the Tuesday morning synchronous sessions, because that's when, also in addition, if you have just questions about stuff, I can answer them as well. Like I said, I'm not gonna re-lecture, but you can certainly ask me questions for clarification. All right, and also it can boost your grade. Taking notes in addition to the notes that I'm providing, you know, the PowerPoint's a great idea. You can use those to help you with the homework. Make some friends, you know, during the sessions so that you can, you know, work together on homework. You can't work together on exams, but you can work together on anything else. Keeping up, and then please, please, please ask me questions. My job is to answer questions, okay? If you don't like answering questions, do not become a teacher. It's literally that simple. Right. I don't like to be lonely during my office hours. I've had students every semester, right? Even last semester online, I had a couple students, they would literally pop up in my office hours and that's when they did their homework, and they would just do their homework quietly. And if they had a question, I was right there. All right. Academic honesty is a big deal, and it's become a bigger issue with the online environment. So like I said, I want you to read through this document. In my class, you know, during a test is really the only time, but the internet has a lot of wonderful information, but I think we've seen over the last few years, it's also a trap. There's a lot of bad stuff. And because you're new with this material, it's hard for you to tell what's the right, what's the good stuff and what's not. So I would go, if you don't understand something, go to my lecture notes first, textbook second, ask me. The internet should be the last place you look. And certainly during an exam, you can't use your book, you can't use your notes, you can't use the internet. All right, so I'm going to make you, like I said, read this. There's a place to sign it and send it to me. Okay, I doubt I'll be making a lot of changes because now that I've done this a couple times, I kind of have a good schedule, but certainly as necessary, I'll do that. All right, so that's enough of me going over things. I guess I'll see you guys on February 2nd at 8:00 in the morning. And I'm looking forward to meeting you and working with you and getting us all through this class. And for the rest of the next couple of days, have a good day, and I'll see you soon. Take care.